You're very welcome back. Today we are bringing a touch of class and sophistication to your Saturday night
dinner.
Thank
you very much for that.
It's right there, isn't it?
Dean Diplock from Breaffy House Hotel Resort, even in Castlebar, County Mayo, is back with a fish dish that's bound to impress the whole family. Good morning, Chef.
Good morning, good morning.
Dean, how are you?
Very well, very well.
Shall we talk about the Lions rugby match, or shall we talk about lobster?
Talk about lobster first. This is guaranteed we're going to win anyway.
Oh, so, Lord, yeah. There's the confidence of the world champions.
Huh?
I think he's right to be confident.
Yeah. Well, listen, lobster. I'm continuing my food exploration and journey in Mayo.
Yeah.
And Joe Garvin from Garvin Seafoods took us out on Sunday and has kindly provided us with some fantastic fish.
Wow.
This is the decent-sized lobster, as they say. I have two other ones ready as well. It's a very simple dish to put together, but certainly worthwhile.
Right.
Don't be scared of working with lobster. It's so easy to work with. Steam it, preferably, rather than boil it, because sometimes the water gets into the carapace and it goes all soft and mushy.
Right.
But just... Oops, there we go. A bit of meat comes off, right? And get yourself a little skewer or something to help pull the meat out when you're emptying it, right? So there's that's that little
beautiful
piece that
product
comes out. Now, the claw itself is probably where a lot of meat is, so just back of the knife. Crack. Other side.
Would you want a pair of goggles for that?
Well, you can get a what do you call it, one of those tongs for it as well, if
yes,
you wanted
of course,
to.
Yes, yeah.
Would be easier. But out it comes a lovely piece of claw meat. And you do the same with the rest of it. You just split it down the middle, open it up like this, and I've taken all the flesh out, and I've just chopped it up into bite-sized pieces. The same I've done with the monkfish. Monkfish is a very versatile fish. It's quite neutral in taste, so when you mix it with a lobster, it takes on the flavors, but at the same time, it's got the same type of texture.
Mm.
So it's very similar. Now, that way, you can really bulk up your lobster dish for the evening. So very simply, I've browned a little bit of onion and garlic. Let me just get this running again. Onion and garlic with a little oil.
I always find lobster a bit mouthy, you know, so I was giving it that.
I'm having a lot of difficulty with this now.
Hey, would you get it? We'll get that inside the Christmas cracker. A bit mouthy.
Yeah, we go.
Sorry, carry on, Chef.
No worries. Right, so into that, I'm going to just put a little bit of butter because we're going to make a roux.
Very good.
In there. And I'm also going to put a little bit of mustard. Now, this is what makes this the crayfish or at least the lobster Thermidor, is the mustard. I'm using English mustard. You can use Dijon, obviously. But you want it to a little bit of a bite to it, okay? It won't overpower the dish, but it will give a little bit of color to it as well, because we're going to end up making a Mornay sauce, which is a cheese-based sauce, which we obviously use a bechamel base to. I've just put a little bit of cognac. We're just going to flambé that a little bit.
We're on fire
now.
It's like Simon's comedy.
It should be up in flames.
Some tasteful jokes around that one, but anyway.
That's
okay,
beautiful.
A little bit of flour. It's only 2 tablespoons, and that's going to give us our roux base.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to just change over there quickly now to the whisk.
And what's your liquid going in there, Chef?
What I'm going to put in here is I'm going to put in milk first.
Okay.
There's 3/4 cup of milk, and then some fresh cream as well. Nice double cream.
Why not?
About 1/4 cup. And we're just going to cook that up, bring it together, and that will be our base. And to that, I'm just going to season it a little bit with some salt and pepper, white pepper preferably. And we're going to add then the cheeses. 2 types of cheeses, Gruyere and Parmesan. Parmesan for that rich flavour. The Gruyere gives you that melty, oozy
You're saying
feel
all the right things, Dean. You really are.
Oozy feel.
Absolutely. So when that comes to the boil, we're going to add... Now, look, as I've cut the pieces up very similar.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason for that is we wanted to be like a mock crayfish or a mock lobster,
good,
so that you can't tell the difference between the two. And when we bake it, we're really going to fill those shells up, and the presentation of it is going to be fantastic.
Beautiful.
This is not very complicated to do. You can buy cooked lobsters as well.
Yeah.
You can ask your fishmonger. Some of them sell them already cooked, but generally you can steam them for about 5 to 6 minutes per pound. And then maybe an extra minute if they're slightly bigger than that. But I wouldn't go more than about 8 minutes is plenty.
If you go to a fancy restaurant, lobster is usually probably the dearest thing on the menu. Is it dear to buy from the fishmonger?
Very much so. Well, it really depends on how big a piece you you want, really. So I'm just putting some Parmesan while we're talking, and I'm going to put a little bit of Gruyere into that.
Oh, Lord.
So, and keep a little bit just to top it off before we bake it in the oven. It is an expensive product, reason being they take so long to grow.
Okay.
You know, they're really, the age of them is really what makes them grow and grow. And they can live up to 100 years or so. So when you get a big lobster, you know it's been around for a while, and you've got to pay for the privilege, basically.
Yeah.
And it's well worth it.
You know what, for a special occasion, though, at home, if you're cooking at home and it's a family occasion, this is
it's
a great
fabulous.
Dish, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. But as I said, this is a nice little trick that you can go a little bit further with.
To fill it
out. A little bit further, a little bit further.
That's
so
amazing,
there's our really thick Mornay sauce, cheesy sauce, to which I'm now going to add the cooked monkfish.
Beautiful.
Like that. And then the cooked lobster.
And a Mornay sauce would go with most white fish, or probably all white fish, would it?
Yes, very much so. White fish, preferably. I stay away from the oily fishes, but it's the white fish. Now, remember, we are going to cook this again, so all you want to do is just basically coat this, get it into the shell, and get it into the oven. Because it's going to be hot, it won't take that very long in the oven. I'd say probably 8 minutes or so in a hot oven, and then just put a little grill on it just to finish it off.
We've got 2 minutes left, Chef.
Plenty time.
Plenty of time. Look.
Plenty of time. So
that.
That then goes
you're
into
right
our
with
lobster
the Gruyere,
shells.
Giving you the old melty, stringy.
Oh, stringy
cheese.
Bits. Oh, absolutely.
Lord. And that's serious portions.
Well, it's done, because Chef. You've got so much of that monkfish in there, as I said.
Yeah,
this
you've
is a nice, healthy portion. Right, I'm just going to leave it like that for now. A little bit of Gruyere on top of it, and that's
oh,
then going
well
to
today,
go.
Son.
Dean, this is, I feel like we're dining in
this is
into the
five-star
oven.
Star
in
dining.
The finest. In
and
the
as
finest,
before,
so a few
we
minutes
have
in
one.
The oven.
We've already had, you want to move your glasses
yes,
there, please, sir?
Certainly.
And I'm just
you
going
didn't
to
do any for Aidan, no?
No, you're not hungry.
It's a two-portion thing, is it? One isn't enough.
I'll pass that down. Fun. There you go, dear boy.
Fantastic.
I don't think you like it, though, Ed. No, it's just that feeling.
I'm just going to garnish yours up
oh,
nicely.
Oh, please do. Yeah, please garnish
right.
away.
Yes.
Look at that.
I'm going to put a little piece of lemon.
Oh, I got a bit of lemon.
Look at that. Are you like me, Simon? You don't want to tuck into it because it's too pretty the way it looks?
No, I'll have no problem tucking
it. Oh, yeah, no problem.
I don't care how well it looks.
Oh,
that's
man,
gorgeous.
That
look
away.
At that. We have a little shot of that, lads. Look at that. So on behalf of the country, I should tuck in. I don't really like eating something heavy this hour of the morning, particularly after I've just finished stretching and warming up.
Indeed, he's done his morning calisthenics.
And cracking his jokes.
Yeah, so 30 seconds left.
Mm.
Now, how does that go? Cheesy. Oh, it is a bit hot, by the way.
It's okay.
Hot.
Mm.
Yeah.
We need to call a doctor. Are you okay, Mr. Delaney?
We've got him quiet for a change.
Oh, man.
Dean, that is just spectacular. We're
lovely.
Spoiled. Thank you so much.
Fantastic.
That's a real treat.
That is a cracking recipe. Thank you, Chef.
Well, come join us on our Facebook page, our LinkedIn, all available at Breaffy House Hotel. Come and see what we're doing. It's really exciting.
Fantastic. Well, recipes for Dean's recipe are up on the website. Or just call into Dean in Breaffy House Resort and try out his wares for yourself. You won't be disappointed.
No.